Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube with some cool scenery tips. Now, I am modeling a transition piece where it goes from the elevated roadbed down to a branch line, which is ground level pretty much. And so what happens when you do that, you're going from like a cork roadbed down to just the foam base, you'll have this gap. So I had to figure out, how do I fill this gap in? Well, I got a popsicle stick. And I figured that's a good enough height for a shim. I'm doing N scale if you've been following along. So I cut a piece, a popsicle stick. I put liquid nails just on the one side. And I glued it to the foam base and put the track back on. And I kind of tested it out. Like, yeah, this isn't going to be too steep. This will be just a nice little transition here. Okay, so I let that dry, or the piece dry. Took the track off. Now, this is not mandatory, but I made just little retaining walls for both sides of where the track marked. Just took some pins. This is just some flimsy styrene. Now, Woodland Scenics makes they call it like paving tape for their Smooth It road system. I didn't have that handy, so I just kind of improvised. It's my first time doing it this way, so you're going to learn like I learn. I did put some green frog tape to cover my main line. I didn't want that getting messed up. So that's where it's going to curve and go down a little gradual hill. Now what I used is Woodland Scenics foam putty. I forgot I had this stuff. And here you also see some ballast that I'm using and some acrylic paints, little mixing cups and some water. So I got all my stuff together. Now the foam putty is pretty cool. I haven't worked with this in a while, but if it comes out a little bit dry, like what happened here, it's supposed to almost be like whipped cream. So I didn't need too much. So you add a little bit of water. Now, I know some people watching this will say, well, why didn't I use joint compound? I could have. Joint compound does crack when you make it too thick. So this, I think, is going to work perfect. Now, I mixed it with a popsicle stick. You don't want it too runny, and you don't want it too dry. So I just add a little bit more water. A lot of this is trial and error. And it's hard filming a video without getting your arm in the way. Okay, now you can add any color you want. I decided just to use a little bit of brown. I'm going to use some brown and black. I very rarely use just one color with anything I do, whether it's painting or whatever. I always like to blend my colors, like the real world. So there's a little bit of brown mixed with some black. It's just that inexpensive acrylic paints. It mixes nicely. Make sure you get it off the side of the cup so that you got it all completely one solid color. I just used the popsicle stick to get it to fill in here. I probably could have made it maybe just a little bit wetter in hindsight. But we'll see how this works out. Now I just used the popsicle stick just to get it in, and then I just took a little piece of styrene. I kind of smoothed it out a little bit. Now, if I was doing like a road with this, yeah, I would definitely make sure that it's nice and smooth. But you'll see how this is all going to work out. Those were just, like I said, just as a guide. Not mandatory. All right. So I'm going to take the styrene and start at the roadbed side. And then nicely start to smooth down with this. Oop, take the pins out. Missed that one. Okay, let's try this again. Got here. All right. nice and smooth. Doesn't have to be perfect, but it'll be a gradual downhill. You're not making that perfectly manicured angles, and now this is the real world we're doing here. Then, when I thought it was good enough, I put the track back on. This will be permanent now. Connected it back to the main line. Now, a little bit as I pushed it down, I did cover up that popsicle stick, by the way. I pushed it down, not too much. I used the main line ballast while this was still kind of soft and wet. I forgot to show you in the mixing cups, but I started with just the same color as the main line, like the real railroads do. They'll ballast maybe 50 to 100 feet into a siding or something with the good ballast. But I gradually added more and more of the black ballast, which is listed as cinders. Because the branch lines, they used a lot of cinders back in the day. Did you know that? From steam engines, they always had so much cinders left over that they would use it with the ballast. Okay, we're letting the foam putty dry overnight with the ballast. Now the next day, I went back and added the mainline ballast, which I forgot to do in the previous video, but that's that. Now that everything's dry, now I can do the regular ballasting with the 50-50 water alcohol mixture like I did in the previous video. You don't want to do this when that foam putty is still wet. And then the 50-50 water with white glue. I think it's probably more 60-40 water. I just made just some dirt for the surrounding scenery. And I just kind of sprinkled in that area. Now this is still considered the railroad's right of way. So look what I do. I put one drop of regular glue. Hey, I got this little pile of railroad ties. How cool is that? Put that in there. Pay attention to real railroads and the right-of-ways. Now this was an old signal mast. I think this was NJ International. Now what happens, here's that history I like talking about, is first I glued down the base because the storyline is this was an old Pennsylvania Railroad signal that just covered the branch line. So they never take out the concrete bases. There's just no money in doing that. So that's a concrete base from this old signal mast with a little bit of rust on it from whenever they just tore out the signal. And what they do sometimes, I'm telling you, railroads are lazy. They will take down an old signal and just leave it lay there for days, weeks, months. What? You don't believe me? Here we are. we got new signals with CSX, and so they just simply laid the old ones here in staging. They've been here for a while. So that's going to be part of the storyline. I love modeling history. Okay, so yeah, I showed you some of the old signals. So we have the concrete base there. We have the old signal laying down to show some time. We're actually going to glue little pieces of foliage or grass around it. And now look how cool that's starting to come out. So branch lines are a lot of fun to model. I had fun doing this. I also like to railfan them. Here's the NS with the local on the branch line. It will come around the bend and up to the main line. This car is actually going to show up on my layout very soon. So yeah, I'm enjoying this. I hope you are too. So subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains, and we're going to be modeling some more coal items like track like this and road crossings and a lot of stuff that makes short line modeling a lot of fun. Go back and check out the old videos too. You'll like them.